In this tutorial, we'll go through exporting an animated scene to Jetset. We're using NVIDIA's Omniverse system and Unreal Connector to translate part of this Unreal scene to USD. And there's a technique with Omniverse that works particularly well for this kind of animated scene. So let's make sure we have the needed Omniverse tools installed. We'll go to Omniverse Launcher. And then we first want to make sure that we have a local Nucleus server here. And you know, we can see here it's up and running. We can see I have local Nucleus service here. And here's our local host, and there's the projects. I've already made a cabbie subfolder and an elevator folder that we're going to store our files in. Back into Unreal, go to our Omniverse menu, add server, and we're going to accept the default local host server. And this connects us to the local Nucleus server that we just saw. We have an animated level sequence of an elevator here. So let's go to our level sequences. Here's our elevator moving up and down. And over in our scene, you can see that we have our elevator and we have a scene locator parented to that in the scene. We already rendered out the far background as a 360-degree Pano in a previous tutorial. So we just want to export the elevator, the scene locator, and a couple of the surrounding buildings so that we can see the scene moving as the elevator descends. So I already put these in the cabbie USD layer, so we can double click that and that'll select all of the items in the layer. You can see which buildings that we're selecting, just the main one behind it. And a couple around it. Now to include the animation in the elevator level sequence, we're going to scroll down and there's our elevator sequence. So we're going to hold down control and click it. And now the elevator level sequence containing the animation is highlighted along with the rest of the objects we're going to export. Now we can right click and choose export to Omniverse. And we don't need MDL for this. However, we'll use our USD preview surface. We won't need the Unreal materials in the phone. And we're going to export as the Y-up axis, as that's what the phone expects. We don't need landscape grass. And we're going to click OK. And we're going to pick we're in our content. We're going to go in content, and here is our Omniverse localhost, just as we specified it. Here's our projects, cabbie, and then elevator. So I'm going to name this elevator descend. All right. I'm going to save. And it's going to start exporting all the various objects in the scene. And the first time that you export it, it might take a little while because it's writing out all of the materials. Okay, so that just exported. That will typically be faster on following exports. And we're going to jump to the Nucleus server we had previously. And it has created, as we see, we're in our elevator panel, and it created a elevator descend 01 USD file. And we actually want to export not just that file, but also the materials and props. So we can just click on the elevator folder and click download. And it's going to zip up a download pretty quick here. And then we can actually just write that download to our USD exports directory. And go ahead and save that. Replace that. All right, here we are in our USD exports directory. And I'm just going to right click on elevator and we're going to extract it all. That's fine. And again, this is our very first export. So we're writing out all the materials and the submodels. We start writing out additional USD files that are just different animations, then we could just export the top level file and we wouldn't have to re-export the materials. All right, so now we can look into our elevator and we see our elevator descend 01 USD file, as well as our materials and props. So now we'll go to Autoshot and I'll open up our models tab. We'll set our model temp folder, the same elevator file, click select, and there's only one USD file in there. And now we can click that and click make USDZ. So it's going to go through that. And with our default 128 pixel texture size and compress all the textures to make it fit into a phone. All right, so it created that. And we'll now go find our freshly created elevator descend USDZ and we'll push that USDZ to Jetset. We have Jetset running, so it's going to just push that file fairly quickly. In Jetset, we can open up the model and elevator descend, there we go. And we'll click on our scene locator of elevator. Okay, we can see our animated model. There's our elevator going by and there's a building coming up. All right, but now we want to add in our 360 backgrounds. We'll click 2D, do import, and we're gonna look for our project images and we'll pick our 360 panel 4. And it recognizes that it's a sphere, that it's a 360 panel. So we'll click sphere. All right, and so you can actually move that around. There's our building that's supposed to be behind us over there. So we'll put that around here. All right, so now we have our foreground images moving and 360 background behind us. We can see our dystopian future. And we're going to want the animation to start at the beginning of the take. So we'll go to settings and we'll click settings. And then we're going to start animation playing at the start of record. Just click that to make sure it's right. And we'll click done. Okay. So now we can roll the take. Going to start with the animation here. And we can pan down and look over. And there's our building coming up. All right, we can click stop. In our next tutorial, we'll bring in the track shot and relink it to the Unreal animated scene.